Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, welcome. Today I will be doing a viral nail art trend that I keep seeing all over social media. You guys probably already seen it. It's pretty much a hibiscus nail art, and I wanted to try that out for you guys and give y'all a little tutorial, so let's get right on to it. Here are the products that I'm going to be using. I have red and black polish and also a nude poly gel by Roslyn, and I'm also using this glow in the dark gel polish by Born Pretty. And y'all are gonna see what I'm gonna do with this is to add like this detail to it to kind of make my set a little bit different. So that's what I'm also using. And I also wanted to show you guys what Savvyland has sent me as well, because y'all probably seen it in the video, but I never really bring much light to it, so I'm gonna show y'all. It's gonna be like a mini unboxing as well. So here I have some UV light gloves, as y'all can see, by Savvyland. So what Savvyland sent me was these UV light gloves, and there's four gloves in total. There's a light pink one, there's a dark pink one. Those are the colors that I picked out, and I'm basically going to be using them in this video. I normally only do one hand, so pretty much gonna have these extras sitting around, but it's something good to have. I know I don't talk about this much, but I think it's important to protect your hands from the UV light. So wear your gloves and also wear your sunscreen as well, preferably 50 SPF or more. And it's important to protect your hands because it can be a bit damaging, especially if you're like me who is constantly doing nails throughout the week and I'm constantly putting my hands through the UV lamp. So it's important to protect your hands. Now, without further ado, let's get started on the nail prep. First, I'm going in with my cuticle pusher and I'm just going to push back my cuticles. And I also like to use the other end to scrape under my fingernails. It's good to do that. Sometimes I have residual gel polish under my fingernail, so it's good to just scrape them. Next, I'm putting on some top coat. But before I do that, let me show you how this glove fits. Okay, so I have very short fingers, so this glove is a little bit long. I had to pull it back a bit, but this is how the glove looks. This looks really nice. I like this. It's a nice change from the black glove. I might have to cut these a bit because I can already see these coming up while I'm doing a nail set, so I'll be right back. Okay, I ended up changing my mind. I ended up folding these back a bit. I was afraid of cutting them. I did not want to ruin these gloves, so I think this turned out better. Next, I'm going to use these square tips. Okay, little side note, this glove is just so soft. Like, I just keep wanting to touch it and rub on it. Guys, these are so good gloves. Now that these are sized out, I'm going to glue them on. Next, I'm going to clip these tips down. Next, I'm going to file these. I'm going to blend the nail in the sidewall and try to get the tip as straight as possible. Thank you. Next, I'm going to get started on the poly gel application. I'm going to use 91% isopropyl alcohol as my soap solution. Just like in the other videos, I'm going to attempt to do one bead instead of two, just to save some time. Now that I'm done with application, I'm going to get a bit of alcohol and a wipe and just wipe these down. Now I'm going to file the nails. Thank you. Okay, so I filed these and buffed these out. Now I'm going to get started on the nail art. Now, to get started with the nail design, I'm going to be drawing French tips for all of the fingers. To get started on the hibiscus flower. So for this I'm going to need my dotting tool. Okay, so I'm using the glow in the dark gel polish first to make the dots. Pretty much put three dots. To get my liner brush, and I'm going to get a little bit of that red polish, and I'm making very thin layer, so that's like really really thin, like this. My camera is not focusing. With the red, I start at the end and I make like these longer lines that curve inward towards each other. And then in the middle, I just create these small little lines and give it like a fringe look so that it can give it that hibiscus flower look. At least that's what I've seen from tutorials online. So this is the best way that I can put it. Wanted to add like these little dots and a line next to it. I don't know what that's called specifically, but that's always something that I've seen with these flower designs and just 90s inspired nails in general. I also added the flower stem and I just drew a line upward and then a dot at the top. It's just really quick and simple. Thank you. Bedazzle to it, so I'm going to add these light ones. To put on some top coat. Next, I'm putting cuticle oil. The final results, guys. Tell me, what do you guys think of this set? I think I did a pretty good job and I'm proud at how these came out. They remind me of like the nails that my mom would get from the nail salon. Well, on very few occasions, because she's not really into acrylics or long nails like that. On the few occasions that my mom would get her nails done, she'd have these like cool designs, you know, like how they have in like the 90s or 2000s, and they look just like this. And I don't know, it just gave me nostalgia, and it has like this modern twist to it, which I really love about this set. So tell me, what do you guys think of this set? Do you like it? Do you think I should have added something more? Do you think I should have done something different? If you guys enjoyed this video, please like it. If you want to see more content, please subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye! It's really hard to see the glow in the dark aspect. You can see the outline of the flower, but it's not very bright. If you're watching this, you definitely have to put your brightness up. So that's my review of the Glow in the Dark Gel Polish. So I'll see you guys later.